Hi, my name's Nick Jennison for Lick Library. Got a lesson for you today on the subject of the piccolo register of the guitar. What, you might be asking? Well, more on that in a second, but before we do, a little something on the gear I'm using for this lesson. Got this beautiful Shergold Masquerader in Dirty Blonde. Gorgeous finish. I'm using it in the bridge position, which I'll tell you why in a moment. Playing through a PV Classic 30. So, the piccolo register, what is it? Well, it's basically notes that exist off this end of the guitar. It's higher than you can play with fretted notes, and it sounds really pretty and dainty, almost like a music box, or perhaps like the really high end of an electric piano. It's a beautiful thing. Let me give you a quick demonstration. Okay, so the eagle-eyed and well-heeled guitarists among you will have noticed that it's basically a collection of pinched harmonics. Now, I want to sell you on the idea today that pinched harmonics are not just the preserve of Zakk Wylde-esque screamers, although that stuff is fantastic. I love that kind of stuff, as I'm sure you can tell from my haircut. But it's a really kind of open field. It doesn't really tie to one genre or another. You can use them in all sorts of creative ways. Now, what I'm doing today is using pinched harmonics that are 12 frets higher than the notes I'm fretting on my left hand, which is a technique used by guitarists like Eric Johnson to access these really ethereal high notes off the top end of the guitar, which is really nice, a cool thing. You might be going, well, if they're not on the guitar, how can they be 12 frets higher? Well, let's talk about what it is to be 12 frets higher than anything. If I take this note here, put it on my 12th fret, I could theoretically imagine a 24th fret. I have 22 on my guitar, but I could imagine a 24th fret somewhere over here. Now, a little clue for those of you who have 22 fret guitars is that the pole pieces of your neck pickup are generally where the 24th fret would be. Now, if you have a 24th fret guitar, obviously you don't need the guidance, you just go to your 24th fret, which is fine. Now, the other thing about this is the distance between here and here, this imaginary 24th fret and my 12th fret, is exactly half the distance between here and the saddle of the guitar. So what we're doing is we're essentially dividing the string in half, and we're picking using a pinched harmonic, which is that thing where you pick and you let your thumb strike the string to activate the harmonic. We're picking exactly over that imaginary 24th fret point. Now, as I move through this little collection of notes I'm using here, as I go from the 12th fret to the 14th fret, what I have to do is move my right hand so that now it's on the imaginary 26th fret, because I've gone up 2 frets with this hand, so I've got to go 2 frets up with this hand as well. And if I imagine it around there, you'll see again, that's pretty much exactly the halfway point between here and here. Now, there is a cheap and dirty way of finding this out, and let me show you that now in case you are wondering and you're planning out your mechanics for this. If you play a note, in this instance I'm going to play this A note here on the 14th fret of the G string, the way to find that upper harmonic is just to tap your pick kind of around the string until you find the note that's one octave higher, and that's where you're going to pick to make this come out. So for me, it's right about there. It's just between where it says Seymour Duncan and where the pole pieces are, and we're gonna get this. Beautiful. And if I go from the pole piece to here, I get. So the thing about this that I think is kind of interesting is it doesn't really sound like a guitar anymore because it's so high and it doesn't have the kind of harmonic twang that you get when you play a nice fretted note. It's a bit more of a pure kind of sound, which sounds maybe more like I say, the high end of an electric piano, or perhaps a synth or even a glockenspiel, some people have described it as, which is pretty cool. If you're feeling creative, you can do all sorts of interesting stuff with melodies that you've written or melodies that you've learned using these kind of ideas. And all we're doing is we're essentially tracing out the movements of your melody with this hand as well as this hand. So for argument's sake, if I played this, which is a G major scale, I would have to mirror the movements with this hand. So you'll see me going from fret to fret. And just to be sure, I can do that dirty little trick where I tap with my pick. Not quite, so let's try again. There it is. Okay, I think I've got a measure of where that's gonna go. Should sound like this. which I think is kind of nice. That's pretty cool. Now, another way that you can get to the piccolo register is using touch harmonics or tap harmonics with your right hand fingers. Now, tap harmonics are the sort of thing that guys like Eddie Van Halen and Steve Vai have been using for decades, and they're generally considered kind of a flashy technique, but they don't necessarily have to be. You can use them to create a similar kind of piccolo effect such as this. And all you do is you simply either tap the string or touch the string at that 12th fret point that we talked about previously. So for argument's sake, if I took the same melody and I took this, rather pedestrian melody, I could do tap harmonics over the pickups and get this kind of sound. Which again has a kind of an ethereal quality. It's a little less attacky than the pinched harmonic, which is kind of nice. But another way you can do this, which I've found quite entertaining, is by simply touching the string rather than tapping it and activating the left hand notes using legato. So you might do this with a combination of hammer-ons from nowhere and pull-offs. So you may play the melody like this. And simply by touching the harmonic nodes at this kind of end of the guitar, in the same place we found them before, you might get this kind of result. So that's kind of three ways that you can access the piccolo register of the guitar. I'm going to urge you just to experiment with this rather than kind of learning any specific licks or tricks. If you already have melodies that you've written or that you know, try playing them using this piccolo register. Maybe stick some cool effects on and try it. You might get some really interesting results, and take them to your band. See what comes out. Anyway, I'm going to leave you there for today. I've got loads more creative type guitar lessons coming up for you, but for the time being, I'm going to sign off. My name's Nick Jennison. I'll see you next time.